I don't know what it is exactly, but somehow the way people are wired, I'm just kind of wired to work. I love working, I love being busy, I love achieving, accomplishing things. Everybody's the same in business. It's how are you performing, how are you doing your job, are you achieving? And I can't really say that's ever been a problem for me. I had a wonderful childhood. I mean, I want to say it was really idyllic. I had two loving, supportive parents. It was happy. It was fun. We did things together as a family. Really what I would wish for everyone else and what I hope, I think, you know, our husband and I certainly tried to give to our children. My parents were both teachers. My father was a math teacher in junior high, and my mother was a third grade teacher. So, you know, you had to, school was important. Well, I was a good student, I'll have to say, but I also must say I probably got in trouble just every now and then for probably talking too much. You know, initially I was going to major in math and be a math teacher or a math professor. And then I got a little taste of, well, I can use that math and that logical thinking, but major in accounting and make more money. And I was very motivated by that, I don't mind saying. I could not wait to start work. I could not wait to start making, you know, at the time what I thought was big money and just working. And it was awesome. I loved it. My first job out of college was with, at the time, Pete Marwick Mitchell, one of the Big Eight public accounting firms, now KPMG. So I was in the audit department and started as an assistant accountant and just moved up that ladder until when I left 6 years later, I was a manager. The company that John founded ultimately became First USA. He put out this compelling vision of what he wanted to do in building this financial services business centered on the credit card and merchant processing business. That was definitely a turning point for my career. So I joined John and became the CFO for the company that he built. Oh, we went through so many iterations. I like to tease and say I was one of the most bought and sold women in business. We had so many changes of control. At the end of the day, it was about a $7 billion transaction then when Bank One came in and bought First USA. I've been with MoneyGram since January 2009, and just in January of 2016, I stepped down as CEO, and I must say one of the greatest things and accomplishments again is to mentor other people. And so it has just given me great joy that folks that I've worked with for so many years, watching their career develop, that's the reward. And when we think about MoneyGram and our business model, we have a foundation. We don't have enough money to give to everything. There are so many wonderful causes. We centered everything around education. Education not only lifts individuals, it lifts families, it lifts whole communities. We know that financial literacy is so important to start very early on. And so I applaud all the great work at JA that they do in getting that instilled at a very early age. You know, success and education, those things are empowering. Empowering for women, empowering for men. And I want the playing field to be the best it can be for everyone to achieve as they desire to achieve for themselves. You know, I may not be in the full-time role anymore, but I feel there's so much more I can continue to do and I want to do and stay involved in business. I love business.